Hi, I'm Oscar Brown Jr. on the Jazz Scene, USA. For over two decades, our guest leader this evening, Stan Kenton, has been to jazz what Ernest Hemingway has been to literature, a vivid figure of creative excitement, innovation, and controversy. Stan's orchestra today is no less provocative as it interprets our age of crises in terms of American jazz. Let's sample some Kentonia right now. Stan and the orchestra whip into Bill Holman's arrangement of the venerable standard, Limehouse Blues. Since the years of World War II, Stan Kenton has blazed trails in big band jazz. He has pushed forward the frontiers of music, and with the aid of many gifted arrangers who worked with him, he's revealed dimensions that were previously unknown to jazz. It used to be said of big band jazz that the soloist got all the glory while the arrangers working behind the scenes got all the black coffee and the headaches. But a band is only as good as its writers. Certainly, the Stan Kenton Orchestra has revealed the talents of a bevy of pen men whose contributions have enriched our world of jazz through the Kenton medium. Here are some of the notable arranger composers who have left their mark on the Kenton Orchestra and on jazz as well. This is Pete Rugolo. And here's the late Bob Grettinger. This is Jerry Mulligan, as talented with the pen as he is with the baritone sax. This is Johnny Richards, whose forte is in the Afro-Cuban vein. And Bill Holman here with Stan. And Gene Roland. Over here, this young man is Lenny Niehaus, who wrote the arrangement, by the way, of our theme that was played by the orchestra at the opening of our show. Let me see, have I forgotten anyone? Almost left out the arranger of the next number you're gonna hear. The song is The Tender All the Things You Are. The arrangement is the work of the piano player.
Thank you.
Stan. Welcome to the jazz scene.
Thank you, Oscar.
It's wonderful to have you. I find this article by you in Downbeat magazine most interesting. You make a point there that student musicians ought to have professional guidance if they're going to get anywhere in jazz. I think it's well taken, but well, why did you, with all the full-time job that you have to do running this big band, decide to take on the additional work of operating jazz band clinics?
Well, Oscar, thank you. It's not just me. There are a number of us that are taking part. We felt that as great as the universities are of music and conservatories of music, that somehow there's something that they are leaving out or omitting, and that is the professional approach to the playing of jazz music and the idea of making a living in music, and we feel that this is the thing that we're stressing at the camps and doing so much good at the clinics.
Well, congratulations. You've helped renew many folks' faith in the future of jazz. What are you and the orchestra going to play for us next?
Well, we have an original composition that was composed by the drummer. He's quite a talented chap, you know, and he's written this composition. His name is D. Barton, and the name of the composition is The Waltz of the Prophets.
The Waltz of the Prophets. Okay, straight ahead. Thank you. These, as you must suspect, are the collected recorded works of Stan Kenton, all on Capitol Records. This LP contains the selection you just heard, and in this album you'll find the number we're going to hear next. It's the haunting Maria from Leonard Bernstein's score, The West Side Story. And the arrangement is by Johnny Richards. Now, hear Maria.
Beautiful, isn't it? What a treasure trove we Norte Americanos find in the music of Latin America. That, of course, was a hint of Malagueña, our next and closing piece. Again, the arrangement is by Bill Holman, and I'd like to direct your attention, if I may, to the mellophoniums in this number. They're the instruments with the big round tubing and the large flaring bells. Here, ladies and gentlemen, is Malagueña.
what's happening on the Jazz Scene USA. Until next time, our thanks to Stan Kenton and his orchestra for playing, and to you for listening and watching. Oscar Brown Jr. Later.